So basically what happened here is a bunch of teenage girls created what's called a fandom around Ed Miliband. It's trended overnight.
Now we've also had Cool Ed Miliband as well.
Cool Ed Miliband. This is, I think, indicative of a similar current of enjoying Ed Miliband as an underdog figure.
They see you as a North London geek.
Projecting him as this cool guy, which started out funny because it seemed so untrue, but now has strangely become true as the irony slips away.
Hell yes, I'm tough enough.
Started out as a joke, but now I think I legitimately fancy Ed Miliband. Do you think Miliband is the most attractive of the leaders?
I'd say so. I met him in real life once.
They look at you and they think, what a shame it's not his brother.
I don't like the fact that he shafted his brother to get the job in the first place.
Having stabbed his brother in the back, Fallon said, Miliband was now willing to stab the UK in the back. It's gonna take a superman to sweep me
off my feet. I don't care what the newspapers write about me. Because what I care about is what's happening to the British people. And I know this country can be so much better.
You know what's kept me going throughout all this is a sort of inner belief of the things I believe in. My motivation is to change the country.
They can't talk about their leader because he's a complete waste of space.
How spicy do you go?
Not that spicy.
Just David Cameron has said that he goes very spicy.
Does he really? So that shows what a tough guy he is. Yeah, yeah.
I followed Mr. Miliband with growing admiration as Labour leader. I think he's been the greatest leader of the opposition since something like Attlee. I mean, certainly since World War II in terms of sheer achievement. He challenged Murdoch over the BSKB shares in the wake of the phone hacking. He took on the press over Leveson. He stopped the intervention in Syria. Now, this broke with the general belief that you always have to support the United States. He ended the cycle of intervention. He came out for a Palestinian state, and he whipped it. And, of course, I forgot to mention his magnificent speech very early in his leadership in which he attacked the big, rapacious, big corporates. And now, of course, he's reaping the whirlwind. A horrible series of personal vindictive attacks which lower and demean our politics.